Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the second half of the Alan Farwell Memorial Concert. I find that quite tasteless. This is quite serious. There was a very bad accident during the interval, ladies and gentlemen. During the interval, Alan Farwell, Peter McAvoy and Len Amadio went up the street to get some cigarettes. And they were wiped out in a car accident, I'm sorry to say. We've just heard news that Peter McAvoy arrived in heaven and said to St. Peter, I'm here. And St. Peter said, what's your name? And he said, Peter McAvoy. And they punched it up on the computer. And he said, St. Peter said to Peter McAvoy, yes, you're on cloud 7, room 9. So Peter went up to cloud 7 and took room 9 and walked in. And there was suddenly a clang and the door closed behind him. And in the corner he saw a shriven, totally repulsive little old man. And a voice said, over the intercom, Peter McAvoy, you have lived a hideous life. You are doomed to live through eternity with this shriveled up, hideous little old man. Next up was Len Amadio, and St. Peter said, name, and he said, Len Amadio, and they said, yes, we know you. You're in cloud 42, room 9, so Mario went up to 42 and into room 9 and the door clanged behind him, and there in the corner was this most hideous, shriveled up little old man. And a voice said over the intercom, Lena Mario, you've lived a hideous life. You are doomed to live through eternity with this hideous, shriveled up little old man. Up came Alan Farwell. And St. Peter said name, and Alan Farwell said Alan Farwell. They punched it up on the computer, and sure enough, there it was. And St. Peter said to him, Alan Farwell, you are on cloud 2, room 5. So Alan walked up the stairs to cloud 2, took room 5 and walked in. The room was empty, not a thing there. And then in walked Mel Gibson. And the door slammed behind him and a voice said, Mel Gibson, you've lived a hideous life. And now, ladies and gentlemen, into the second half of our Alice Awards. To present the awards for Drama Queen of the Year, Bitch of the Year, and whether you like to believe it or not, Virgin of the Year. Two people whom I can only introduce as Adelaide's Arsenic and Old Lace, Bob Francis and Anne Wills.
That's enough. Thank you very much indeed, and I'm glad to be here. Ladies and gentlemen, if I could just say one thing before we do the nominations, I would like to say a very special thank you to the fact that South Australia, I'm proud to be a South Australian, proud to be involved in so many shows like this. This is a totally professional, fantastic, and only people like Brian Bergen and Susie Ng and Phyllis Southgate, who is such a delightful lady, could put something like this together. and make a totally satisfactory cut.
And what I love about it, it's the first show I've ever been to where I've been totally underdressed.
The nominations for the Laurie Oakes, Silver Alice for Drama Queen of the Year are Rose Lee, Greg Daish, and Dean Rogers.
I feel just like, well, I don't feel like him at the moment, no. Greg Evans at the Logies. Oh, Alex, I'm so proud of you. You've got them, you little gossip. Oh, and I'm so proud of Tony Roberts and Stubbsy, all my mates. The winner, the Drama Queen of the Year, Rose Lee.
So beautiful, Rose. That's heavyweight.
Drama Queen of the fucking year! I have five people I would really like to thank. First of all, I would like to thank my mother. Because that's what they do at the Academy Awards. Second of all, I would like to thank Miss Maggie Scott because she taught me how to use the word fuck. Third of all, I would like to thank Don Storm because he made me what I am. Fourthly, I would like to thank Sky Brooks. Because Sky Brooks, without Sky Brooks, I've got nothing to bitch about. And lastly but not least, I would like to thank Miss Phyllis Southgate because without Phyllis we wouldn't have a real true drag queen. Thank you very much.
Rose Lee. Cheers, your lipstick tastes shit ass.
Did you kiss her on the mouth? Dirty thing. Vomit. Do you know? I feel much better. Now, look, I've got to tell you a true life story. It happened to me last Saturday week ago. Stubbsy and I, Peter Stubbs and I, and a couple of other people, Denise Marcos, just for your name. Oh, by the way. Oh, I'm sorry. Stephen Hayter rang me yesterday from Chicago and sent you all a big kiss. However, we went to a restaurant called Da Clemente. I thought it was called Duck Lament. And I ordered chicken breasts for my dinner. And this little guy came over and he had a plate for one for me and a plate for the girl next to me. And he said to her, "You just the crab?" And she says, "Yes." And he looked at me. It's a true story. God is my witness, so is Peter Stubbs. He looked at me and he said, "Chicken breast?" And I said, "Oh, thank you very much." He pissed off and didn't leave my plate at all. I had to eat Stubbsies. It was awful. Oh, what am I doing? Bitch of the Year? Oh, Bob's fainted. He's having a bad time.
I'm here, yeah.
Nominations. Nominations for the Richard Carlton Silver Alice Bitch of the Year. Janet Walsh. Judy McPherson. Damien Cartel. And me.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, the Bitch of the Year is Janet Walsh. Janet, is this something you're proud of?
Well, you know I'm not the full boxing dyke. Thank you, Mary Davidge, for standing down for this one. Thank you.
Ah, oh, what a bitch. What a bitch. Did you like a frock?
I like the frock, yes I did. There's a lot of frocks I like here tonight. I wonder if I can borrow some. I love that gold one that's out the back there, the big one. Oh, it's wonderful. It's like something I should wear. Hey, anyway, what I want to know, you tarts, is what the hell you're doing here and not watching movie bloody scene. It's all right, I've got it on tape, we're going to show it later.
And, who made your clothes tonight?
I made this one. I did. I should have spent more time, eh? Yes.
Yeah. From what I've known of you in the last 20 years, you've made the whole lot of them. They're all shit ass.
Oh, I don't care. At least I'm bloody consistent, aren't I? I don't care. I keep getting voted the worst dressed personality on television in Adelaide, and I'm fucking proud of it! It's not easy being white.
Fancy being in a situation like this tonight.
Yeah.
And to be introduced as the sexiest woman in Adelaide.
No.
You got fat chance tonight.
No. I was voted the sexiest television female personality in Adelaide. Yes. Of course, they did the survey in the blind ward of the geriatric hospital. I don't care. It's nothing to do with what I wear.
I've got to say, the reason why we're bullshitting on here is we've been told to stretch.
Yes. It already is.
I rather think the earrings have a special significance tonight with you, Anne, are they?
Oh, no. Oh, these earrings are from Giorgio's and Rodeo Drive, Los Angeles. They are, truly, and Alex wanted to wear them, but I said no. He can have them tomorrow night when he goes to the Green Dragon. Next year, could I be one of them, like bitch of something of the year?
I
think we're stretched enough.
If you go to the Green Dragon long enough, Don Storen will nominate you for bitch of the year.
Ooh.
There's only one nomination next year.
Oh, what does that mean?
It's you.
You know what really pisses me off? I've been watching some of these guys dancing, going, "Oh shit, that's gorgeous," and the guy next to me wins him.
The nominations for the Keith Martin Silver Alice for the Virgin of the Year. Lou Paredes. Here's a good name, Davina Crackett. That's a bloody good name. Davina Crackett. Jesus, change your name to Fred. And I want to read them again. The Keith Martin Silver Alice for Virgin of the Year, Lou Paredes, Davina Crackett, and Les Miller. Annie, I hope the hell it's not Davina Crackett. The winner is...
I'm just over with cum here. The Virgin of the Year. How do you say that? Lou Paredes. Yeah.
This is the guy I was in the toilet with a little while ago. And I couldn't have a pee, and you were saying, have a look at this. And you're the bloody virgin. Jesus Christ. I didn't want to put you off, Lou. How the hell could you be a virgin with one that size? I've prayed to the Lord to have one that size.
All I'd like to say is that I'm...
Getting close to the microphone, Lou.
I'm flushed with success at this year's award. And that next year I hope to go for Slut of the Year. So that all you hopefuls out there, please meet me in the loo, that's a pun, in about 20 minutes time, and I will get well underway for my next award. Thank you very much.
God, I'm glad I've been there already. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the sex symbol of the year on television and myself, thank you very much for inviting us to be here tonight.
Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to present the Silver Alices for the Sugar Daddy of the Year and the Spunk of the Year, two of Adelaide's beautiful people, Mr. Scott McBain and the stunning Adriana Exeneri.
Actually, it's been quite an interesting night tonight. I must admit that this is the first Alice Award that I've been to, and the show so far has been superb, some top quality entertainment. And I was only saying to Phil Edgar, just over at the bar before, that the bodybuilders that were on, they were built like brick shithouses, and Phil said yes they were, and I suppose if anybody knew about brick shithouses, Phil would. And another thing that I have noticed is that there's so many friendly people here tonight. I mean, I went to the toilet to take a piss. I was no sooner in the door than four blokes asked me if I wanted a hand. But really, it has been a lot of fun. A lot of fun. I'd like to give you now the nominations for the Lionel Williams Silver Alice for Sugar Daddy of the Year. And they are Trevor Royal, Frank Sterk, and Wilbur Radus.
And the winner for Sugar Daddy of the Year, Trevor Royal. Woo!
There ain't nobody better than me. Can't you see?
Connected with tonight, because it is very, very nice for the gay community to present something as great as this and to show the South Australia that we are not just ordinary people, we are the greatest. To the people, the presenters, and everyone that's connected with it, it's a credit to them, to the committee and everyone like that. Thank you for presenting a great night, and I'm very, very proud to be part of it and to be part of the gay community, because we are what we are and we're proud of it. A daddy I am asked my son Simon, Sugar, Jesus, hadn't been much lately. Never. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Trevor. Our next nomination is for the Bill Collins Silver Alice for Spunk of the Year. And the nominations are Nick Petho, Mark Hodge, and Paul Muller.
And now the winner for the Bill Collins Silver Alice for Spunk of the Year. I'd like to meet Fanny Farwell. Is she here? She sounds like an interesting... Oh, sorry. I'd still like to meet her. I mean, anyone that can get that many mentions has got to have something going for her. For Spunk of the Year, Mark Hodge.
Nobody better than me. Can't you see?
Sorry about the black, but I can't get out of it. They took me by surprise. I didn't know about it until tonight. I knew I was being nominated, and then they just came and dressed me all of a sudden. I'd just like to thank everyone for being so good tonight. It's really good to have a fantastic audience to work with. And I'd like to thank my mother too. She's up the back there tonight.
And gentlemen, the president of the Academy of Alternative Arts and Sciences and ex-friend of Fanny Farwell, Mr. Brian Bergen.
It's different over this side. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the, as I always say, the one serious moment of the evening. As you all know, the Academy, every year, if there is somebody worthy of it in our estimation, invites a person who has contributed considerably over a period of time to join our Hall of Fame. This year, ladies and gentlemen, it is our great pleasure to invite somebody from outside our own boundaries of South Australia to join our Hall of Fame. Somebody who started an amazing career in South Australia. Somebody who has gone on interstate to build on that career and give an enormous amount of pleasure to a great number of people over a great time. A person who is big-hearted, a person who is understanding, a person who really deserves the title of a good person. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Academy of Alternative Arts and Sciences, I have the honour to ask into our Hall of Fame the one and only, from Melbourne, Jan Hillier.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host for the evening, president of the Fanny Farwell Fan Club and everybody's mother, Mr. Brian Bergen.
What can I say? I think for the first time I'm stuck for something to say, and that's been a never in all my life. All I can say is that to receive this award is a great honour. And I've spent 18 years running gay venues, and I hope that I've pleased an awful lot of people. But most of all, I can't leave this stage without saying it. I couldn't have done it without the wonderful bunch of staff that I've got that work for me. Thank you very much.
For the evening, President of the Fanny Farwell Fan Club and everybody's mother, Mr. Brian Bergen.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the highlight of the evening, to present the major award for 1985, the Gold Alice for Personality of the Year, a person who himself tomorrow receives an extremely high honour, a person who tomorrow is admitted as a member of the Order of Australia. I'm sorry, today, it's past 12. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Len Amadio AM.
Thank you, Mr. President. Well, it's been a wonderful night, and I don't know how many people to congratulate, but I think I just should say very quickly that Mark and Michael have been outstanding. I think we'd all agree with that, right? Now, last year the President of the Academy made a very, and I was told I'm not to talk very long tonight, so I won't. Yeah, I'm sure you'll all be delighted, right? The President of the Academy made a very long statement about the origin of the Alice Awards, and he didn't give you any answer. And all I want to know, to tell you is that that Alice doesn't live there anymore in a well-known establishment south of Park Lands in Adelaide. But the phone number's the same if anyone's interested. And I've gleaned that from 12 months of investigation, so you'll have to wait till next year to find out. Now, we have the nominations for the Tim and Debbie Gold Alice for Personality of the Year Award. And they are Maggie Scott, Chrissy Simon, and David White.
There is a word to describe Maggie Scott. Huge. Huge in talent, huge in generosity and compassion, huge in intellect and forbearance, and huge in the milk of human kindness. Ladies and gentlemen, the hugely popular Maggie. There is a word to describe Chrissy Simon. Unbelievable. Unbelievably elegant, unbelievably zany, unbelievably cute and cuddly, blessed with an unbelievable sexual appetite. Ladies and gentlemen, the totally unbelievable Chrissy Simon. There is a word to describe David White. Magnificent. A magnificent entertainer, endowed with a magnificent presence, magnificently creative, magnificently funny. Ladies and gentlemen, the magnificently proportioned Sky Brooks.
And wait for it. The Personality of the Year is Maggie Scott.
A few words. About a year ago, Don Storen put a microphone into my hand, and I'd like to thank Don. We've been in trouble ever since. Don. To Sky Brooks, I think I speak for all the members of the Galaxy Girls cast when I say in the past couple of weeks she's taught us what friends and truth and understanding really is. And about 3 or 4 years ago, I really didn't think that trannies were very accepted on the gay scene. And then all of a sudden in this year you've taught me that you really do like me, and I think that's really great. And so if you do like me, if it means being accepted as gay, then I'm proud to be gay, and I'm glad to be from South Australia. I love you.